Hello beloved, trust you're doing fine. Welcome to my channel. Mine is a fairly new channel dedicated to offer recovery tips to people suffering from anxiety disorders, GAD in particular. I myself suffered from GAD for 17 long years before making a complete recovery. I've made a video on how I recovered from GAD, which I have put in the description box above. So please check it out when you have the time. I'm not a clinical psychologist, but I'm interested in becoming one. I'm not an orator either. Therefore, I'm going to read from the script I've written down so that I don't miss out any relevant points. Subtitles can be enabled if you can't follow my accent. I happen to be a huge fan of therapist Emma McCarron, and regularly view her YouTube channel, Therapy in a Nutshell. I'm currently binge watching her video series on how to process emotions, which I think has its foundation in ACT and CBT. When I suffered from generalized anxiety disorder, I had even taken one of her courses on Udemy on mental health and neuroplasticity. In the course, Emma taught ways to overcome anxiety by focusing on the concept of neuroplasticity, which basically says that our brains continue to grow throughout our lives. Apart from nutrition, exercise, like therapy et al., Emma taught techniques to relax anxiety emanating from the amygdala and ways to strengthen the parasympathetic response. Her course included a host of techniques like deep diaphragm breathing, PMR, that progressive muscle relaxation, and a host of other relaxation techniques. Incidentally, I've made videos on the two pathways that create anxiety and why we must address anxiety arising from the amygdala first. You can find them in the description box above. Now coming back to Emma McCarron's course on mental health and neuroplasticity. By doing her course, I realized that Emma intends desensitizing her patients to the anxiety response by using relaxation techniques. Her techniques did help, but the method that helped me recover completely from generalized anxiety disorder was at the opposite end of the spectrum. It was a method for curing nervous illness developed by Dr. Claire Beach way back in the 1960s. More about the technique has been put in the description box above. Dr. Claire Beach's technique has been worked on and popularized by Barry McDonough as the DARE response. It's a response which advises you to welcome your anxiety by diffusing it, accepting it, running after it, which is basically saying, give me more of that feeling, and engaging in doing something productive while having an anxiety attack. Dr. Claire said that the anxiety loop was being kept alive and kicking in patients by secondary fear, that is, adding fear of symptoms to the original fear. Dr. Claire did attribute anxiety to wrong core beliefs, a distorted worldview, or anything like that, but dismiss the anxiety response as a random, unbalanced response of an overactive nervous system. She was extremely critical of attempts of behaviors to desensitize patients using relaxation techniques. In her course on emotional processing, Emma teaches us to feel emotions instead of fighting or suppressing them, which is pretty much in sync with Dr. Claire Beach's theory. In a video titled Willingness, Emma teaches us to feel our emotions by describing what we're feeling, being curious about our emotions, being present in the moment, and so on. At one point, she also asks us to make our anxiety worse, which is what run after in the DARE response is all about. However, in her course on neuroplasticity, Emma asks us to desensitize the nervous system by using relaxation techniques. I'm a bit confused by the dichotomy in her approaches and would love to have an explanation either from her or anyone else who is watching this video. I know Mommy Academy has live Q&A sessions, but I don't think they could accommodate long multiple queries. Let's move to that too I have, and let me begin with an example. I am a professional IWE, that is an Indian writer writing in the English language. Obviously, English isn't my first language. I've had to work very hard to reach a level of proficiency, assuming I've reached it at all. About 4 years ago, I tried to pick up another foreign language, Spanish, while trying to improve my English. I practiced the vocabulary and grammatical rules of the language, and even tried watching Spanish movies the whole day long. My Spanish improved by the day, but I noticed another interesting phenomenon. My command over English began to grow weaker by the day. So yes, like Amma Kaden taught in her course, the brain can expand and change to accommodate new information. We can work towards changing our core beliefs and develop new ways of perceiving the world, enabled by the development of new neural pathways. Let's assume I've changed a few of my unhealthy core beliefs to be free of anxiety disorder today. Now, coming to the doubt that I have, which will hopefully be cleared by Emma or by the viewer watching my video, you can feel free to use the comment section below. Is there a chance that I've lost or could potentially lose previously acquired skills or information in my brain that are important to me? Can our brains change and expand without compromising on previously acquired skills? Okay, that's all for now. Thank you so much for watching my video. Please like, share, and consider subscribing to my channel. Have a lovely day. Namaskar.